Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This video is going to be about Moodle. It's about design in Moodle. I'm going to just show you a couple of tips on how you can make your Moodle courses look a lot more professional. What I'm going to do is I'm going to draw on some real courses that I've produced and show you examples. And these couple of tips will really help you to make your courses clearer, easier to navigate, and look a lot more professional. Now, hopefully you're watching these videos either on Facebook or on YouTube. So if you've got any questions, please leave questions and comments in the comment section below. And if you can, please like the videos as well. And thank you very much. One of the biggest problems with designing courses in Moodle is that you often end up with loads and loads of links. So if we, for example, look at this section of the course, we can see here there's masses and masses of links. Now, we could have added a description. I was obviously trying to exaggerate a little bit how it works, but you can see the point that there's really nothing visual on the screen. Now, I want to contrast that with just a simple example here of a course that I've run or I created for an organization called Quality Language Services. And here are immediately you can see that we've got a nice title, we've got some text, and then we've got some visual elements on the screen. So we can simply change it so that actually the access in the content doesn't require you always to click on the link, but rather some of the content might actually be directly on the screen. And I'm going to focus on two simple techniques that I use to make that possible. Let's get straight into it. So if we look at this course here, there's one obvious thing that we could do immediately that would improve this. If we was to come up here onto the section where the title is and just simply click on edit and click on edit section. And what we're going to do here is just take away the default title, come down underneath, and I'm just going to grab a picture. So I'm going to click here and then I'm going to sort of browse my repositories. In fact, I should be able to find this image here in recent images. So I'm just going to click on this image. And then I'm going to select that file and click on save image. Now immediately that means that there's kind of something now at the top of the screen. So instead of it just being loads and loads of links, I've actually added up an image. Okay, now what I'm also going to do is just click on that image and just bring that into the center. So by using the kind of text align tool, I can do that. Click on save changes, and immediately now what that's going to mean is the top of that section has at least a title. Now it would be a good idea as well to actually add some description underneath, so I can easily go back to that title. Okay, click again on add section, and just underneath here, I'll stop the video for a minute. So I've just gone back again and added in some text, and I'm doing a little trick here where I kind of use, in Moodle you normally have very specific sizes that you can use, medium, heading, and I like using these because it means that everything's consistent. So I've already used medium heading here and I'm going to use it here. So all I've done really is just put, you know, added some text underneath, and hopefully this will start to look a little bit more professional. Okay, so instead of just having those loads of links, now we kind of got something visual on the screen. Now what's the problem here? Let me try to explain what the problem here. The problem here is the use of labels, and that's what I want to focus on next. Now the problem with Moodle when you add what we call either activities or resources here. Okay, so if we click on this button here and we add a lot of these resources or buttons, or sorry, resources or activities, the result of that is that they create a link. And sometimes you don't want that. Now it's impossible to avoid not having links on the page. There are certainly going to be times when you're going to need links, but you may want to visualize things on the screen rather than always just have links. So what you can see at the moment here is that these are all links. So these are various things. For example, we've got here, you know, chats, and of course pages, etc. But the one that will actually visualize on the screen, so will actually appear on the screen rather than simply be a link, is if we use a label. And I'm going to demonstrate that by clicking here on add a label. So I'm going to come down to label. We're going to add a label onto the screen. And immediately you'll see that labels work in a different way, because when you click on add a label, it immediately says, well, what content do you want on that label? So immediately when you create a label and you place the content in, that content is visualized. Now the label could include video, it could include pictures, etc. Now I'm actually going to add up some video content, because it might be nice after or at the top of the unit to have a quick video explanation of what is going to happen in this particular unit of the course. Now I'm going to show you a couple of tricks in with the labels, all right? So the first thing I'm going to do here is write video introduction. So we're going to have a video introduction onto the screen. I'm going to do the same thing as I did earlier, select that, and I'm going to use this consistent idea of making sure that everything is medium heading. I'm going to paste some text in here. So I've just copied some text. I'm just going to paste that text in. And then underneath that text, I'm now going to add a video. So I'm going to click here. Remember, anything that we do in this format will actually appear on the screen. Now, this is not going to look very good at the moment because we'd need to do quite a lot of work to tidy up the whole unit, but hopefully it will give you a bit of an idea of what I mean. So now we've got a kind of title and we've got a video, and we're just going to save that now. And once we save that, we'll be able to see what that starts to look like on the screen. So I'm just going to click here and see what we have produced. Now, coming to this particular section, we've now got a kind of label here at the top, which we use by editing what I call, well, what's basically the actual title section at the top. And then the first content we've added onto the screen now is actually in the form of a label with an explanation and then a video underneath. Now, of course, all these labels are still here, unfortunately, and we need to tidy those up. There could be lots of different tricks, and that's really another video, but I'm going to just show you one simple thing that you could do that would help to make this look a little bit more professional. So what I'm going to do, just going to switch back to my principal role because I'm logged in now as a participant to actually just look and see what that was going to look like. I'm going to come down here and just show you a quick improvement that you could make to this course. So I need to turn the editor back on again. And we're going to add a label again, and I'm just going to show you a little trick that we can do here. And I'm going to come to labels, and I will come down here, choose label, click on add, and simply I'm going to put here chat. Okay, so I'm just going to put here chat. Okay, and then I'm going to select that and choose again to make that consistent. So I'm going to use the medium and say, this is the chat to the unit on distribution. Okay, I'm going to save that as a label. Remember, that's going to be visualized on the screen. This is just a simple technique that could improve the way your course looks. Now, if I move that up to here, okay, and put that underneath whatever section it's meant to be, and we've got the chat here, in fact, so if I put the chat underneath, then what you can immediately see is that I could begin to do that to every section. So I could have a label plus the link, a label plus the link, a label plus the link, and we could begin to add more and more labels to make the content look a bit more organized. Okay, so rather than simply just having a link, we've now got a quick description, a title plus a description, then the link title. So I would add more and more labels, and that would immediately tidy this up and make it look visually more appealing. Now, those were just two really simple techniques that I'm using there. One is how you can go to the actual what you might call the section header at the top of each section of your course and edit that and add in an image there, because that will also visualize on the screen. And then the other thing I've done is that I began to use labels to visualize some of the content on the screen. And by doing that, you begin to create a bit of a balance, and you don't always have masses and masses of links. And then the third thing that I suggested is, where you have got links, add a label above each link with a title, with a description, always using the same size, and eventually you'll make that course look a lot more attractive visually, easier and clearer to navigate. I hope you found that video useful. If you were accessed it on Facebook or on YouTube, as I said, please leave any comments, any questions, and if you can, like the video. If you want more content, and a good place to come is to teachertrainingvideos.com. There's a whole section here of free content at the top, including lots more videos on using Moodle. And also on the front page here, there's a few different topics if you're interested in things like the flipped classroom or blended learning, etc. If you really want to keep up with what I'm doing, then I suggest also that you sign up to my newsletter, because that way you'll always know of any new videos that I've put onto YouTube or put onto Facebook, or any new videos that have gone up onto the website. But also you'll know about any webinars that I'm running or any short courses that I'm currently running. And really hope you found that video useful, and thank you very much.